There's a lot of weight movement going on here.
Okay.
With the crown. There's a Kevlar crown in there.
Mm-hmm.
So with the Kevlar being sandwiched between the graphite, it's great feel and sound. But it also allows us to move about 13 grams down low. So we hit the 9 degree. Specifically, all that extra weight is targeted front. So guys, we are covered speeds. The biggest problem, the concern usually is spin rates. So we're adjusting spin rates with the 9 degrees.
It's a cortex, yeah.
And then when you get down to that set, you get the 13 degree, it's more heel bias further back.
Yeah.
To get that more high ball flight, more spin. So
the feel was incredible. I felt like I could really go after this and not be afraid of losing my accuracy. I mean, I felt really good with that.
Good.
Yeah, I'll tell you, with that. With the Kevlar, with the sound in that, it's like when Roger Federer uses a tennis racket.
Yep.
He has used since he was young pup all the way now. All the rackets have Kevlar.
Okay.
And he does that for feet.
Now, when you say Kevlar, what is...
Kevlar is a material. It's not as... So graphite is your structure.
Okay.
That's for strength. Or it can be for... contouring and the molding when you use a weave on it.
Okay.
But Kevlar is your vibration amber.
I don't even go.
Graphite's not a vibration amber, it's more that structural. So Kevlar is used for like bulletproof vests. It absorbs vibration. So it could be an impact, it could be sound.
So then
and both of that comes from Kevlar.
Okay. And are y'all one of the only companies that do that? Kevlar? So y'all have that technology unique to Wilson?
We have it unique.
Okay.
I mean, but Kevlar has been out for a while. Other sporting things. In fact, I think they used it in golf shafts at one point. But, you know, because it's real. But it's just.
Nobody's put it in the hand until now.
No. Oh, wow. The crowns in there.
So the
it costs you some money.
Yeah.
You know? And so, but this is all featured to be very efficient and optimized for the fights. That's why you don't have the adjustability. A lot of times, you know, we did a lot of research and 80-some percent who have adjustable drivers. Half of them only adjusted it once. Mainly coming out of your point of sale.
Right.
And about 35% of them adjust. They go in, you need a 9 degree stiff, and you get 5 competitive.
I want to hit, so later I'm going to hit the
blue. It's like which one they like the best, and one is the way it goes home. So it's very efficient.
That's great call. Thanks for your time on that. Appreciate it. We're gonna